Are you looking to create more eye-catching content for your digital displays? Well, if you have multiple screens, then I have the answer for you. Today, I'll be showing you how to make multiple screens act as one using our new video wall feature. This provides an easy way for you to dramatically enhance your digital signage displays. I'll show you how to set it up and how to create custom content using our video wall app. For an example, I'll be turning a three-screen setup into a bike shop products and services board, and then I'll add some compelling footage that flows across all three of the screens. So, let's get started. What is a video wall? It's when you have multiple screens and you combine them to create the illusion of one single screen. This gives you a larger area to display content and lets you utilize unique dimensions. Using a video wall is a great way to grab the attention of your customers and ensure you get eyes on your content. With just a little bit of creativity, you can make some absolutely stunning displays that cannot go unnoticed. So what do you need to create a video wall? To start, you'll need the proper hardware. Our OptiSigns Pro Series players are the way to go. This would include the Pro Player, which can support up to three screens, or the Pro Max Player, which can support up to four screens. In this video, I'll be using the Pro Player. You are going to need 2 to 4 screens and HDMI cords, depending on your setup. And lastly, you'll have to purchase the video wall add-on within your OptiSigns account. Here, I have my Pro Player connected to one screen and paired to my account. So now I need to connect my other two screens to my Pro Player. Now, an important note here is do not connect your HDMI cords at random. Port number goes left to right and top to bottom, depending on your video wall layout. For my three screen setup, HDMI 1 will go to my far left screen, HDMI 2 will go to my middle screen, and HDMI 3 will go to my far right screen. Now I need to activate video wall within my OptiSigns account. To do this, log in to OptiSigns. Once you are logged in, go to your screens tab, locate your player, and select edit. Open the advanced dropdown, scroll down, and open the more dropdown. Scroll down again, and select activate next to video wall. A little warning will pop up asking if you want to create a video wall. Select activate. If you haven't purchased the video wall add-on yet, then you will be prompted to do so. Otherwise, your player's video wall has been activated and you'll be brought back to the edit screen. We'll click on change. Here's where you will select your layout that matches your screen setup. Notice the numbers on the screens. Those tell you where the HDMI port should be going. So make sure your HDMI cords are going into the correct screen or your content is not going to show the way you want it to. I'd also like to point out the pixel dimensions here. This tells you the size of the content that will show on your screen. These numbers are set for high definition. Now, if you have screens that support 4K, then you can utilize 4K dimensions for your content. So go ahead and select your layout. Now you can select save. Once you hit save, you'll notice your screens are going to update as well. Your content will no longer just be on HDMI 1, but rather it will be centered across all the screens. That's how you set up your video wall. All we have to do now is push content to our screens. Our video wall app is made specifically to create custom content for screens utilizing video wall. To access the app, go to your files and assets tab, select apps on the left-hand side, and then search and select video wall. Just like when we selected our layout for our screens, we're going to select it for our app. Go ahead and start by naming your wall. You'll notice your screens are set up as zones, and on the left-hand side is where you can add content to each specific zone. I'm going to add my assets that I've already made, one for each screen. You can also name the zone for each screen. I like to name mine screen 1, 2, and 3. Over on the right-hand side, we have the preview button. Next to the preview button is the push to screen option. Mine is grayed out right now. That's because I haven't saved the asset. So once I hit save, I'll be able to push to screen directly from this page. Next to that is the gears icon and merge screens. I'll touch more on that with the other content we'll be creating. So I have my video wall set up. I have it saved. My preview looks good. I'm good to go. So I'm gonna add this video wall content to the playlist. If I wasn't using a video wall here, then every time I wanted to make an update to each piece of content on here, I would have to publish 3 times to 3 different screens. Whereas with this approach, all I have to do is open the video wall asset and just make edits here, hit save, and it will automatically be published to those playlists or schedules it lives on. So this will save you lots of time in the future. So let's just keep going off this playlist. I will go ahead and publish to my screen now. My content's live. It looks great on screen. Now I'm going to add some other content to cycle on my screens. Let's open up the video wall app again. And now I want to add a video that goes across all 3 of my screens. To do this, we're going to want to merge the screens. So start by selecting merge screens and then select all the screens you want to merge. For my case, I want them all to be acting as one. Once you have your screen selected, click on the green icon that has arrows pointing towards each other. Now I have 1 zone for all 3 of my screens. I'll add my video here. If I select preview, you'll notice my video does not cover all 3 of my screens. It's not big enough. It's not the right dimensions. So if I click on fit to screen and select zoom, that'll zoom it in until every space is covered. So that's a great option for me. I'm gonna hit edit and then preview again to update my preview. And I like it, it looks great. I'm going to hit save. Then I'll close there and let's add it to my playlist. Now, one other thing I wanna point out is if you have content that is the proper dimensions, then you don't have to worry about using the video wall app. You can just publish it to your screens or place it into your playlist, just like I did here. There is one more feature to the video wall app I'd like to show you. So I have my static promotions playlist and I have my videos playlist. Each playlist has the same amount of content. I want the first video to play when the first promotion is showing. And then I want the second video to play when the second promotion is showing. Let's open up the video wall app and get these playlists synchronized. First thing I'll do is I'm going to merge my 2 left screens. I'm going to add my video playlist to those screens. And then I'll add the static playlist to my far right screen. And I'll just hit save for now. With this current setup, my promotions playlist and video playlist will not play in sync, right? They're each going to follow their own playlist duration settings. If I go to my playlist, you'll notice each piece of content has different timing on it. My first video is 15 seconds long and my promotions playlist first image is 10 seconds long. I'll fix this by going to the gears icon and opening the video wall configuration settings. I'll start by making the primary zone the left side, so that's the videos playlist. And I'm going to have my right screen use primary zone playlist timing. This will ensure that the promotions playlist will only change content when my video or primary playlist changes content, right? So they'll change content at the same time. One thing to note here is that your zones have to use playlists and they have to have the same amount of content. Otherwise, this feature will not work. And lastly, I'm going to turn on respect primary zone video timing. This option only goes into effect if you place this asset into a playlist. And what that does is when we place this promos and videos asset into a playlist, that playlist is going to respect whatever my primary zone's playlist duration is. It's not going to cut off one of these videos in the middle of it. It's going to let it play. It's respecting the primary zone's playlist. So that is a wordy explanation, but don't worry, I'm going to give you a visual of it right now. So let's hit save and let's add it to our playlist. You'll see there is a duration setting right here, but we had respect primary zone timing on, right? So what that means is this 10 seconds doesn't really matter. It's going to play the duration of this video, 15 seconds, before it goes on to the next content in this playlist. Let's do a preview here. If we set this to 3 seconds, we'll do 5 as an example. And our first content in the video playlist is 15 seconds. So if we hit preview here, we'll move it to the top so it's quicker. So when we hit preview, you're gonna notice that video and that static image are gonna show for longer than 5 seconds. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there you go. It's respecting this zone's timing. So that's great. That played for the full duration of the video. Now let's go back to this asset and let's turn that off. Hit save. Then when I go to that playlist right here, it's at 5 seconds. Now when I hit preview, it's only gonna show for 5 seconds and then it's gonna go to the next content. So right there, only showed for 5 seconds. I'm gonna go ahead and turn that back on. Don't wanna forget that. That last feature is pretty advanced, but it can be very helpful if you know how to utilize it properly. So that's my playlist. Let's push to the screen, take a quick view of it and see how it looks live in action. Here we have our products and services board that we can change within the Video Wall app itself. And then after that, we have specific promotions always showing at the same time. And then after that, we have some very compelling footage. I hope this video has shown you how video walls can easily enhance your digital display visual experience, along with how it can save you time and effort with managing your content. If you have any questions, please reach out. It's our job to make sure OptiSigns works for you. Now it's your turn to go out and make some compelling content of your own using a video wall. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.